Good morning, John. So in my last video, I was all
to make a video about the James Webb Space Telescope.
And then the nerdiest of the nerds in the comments were all, so today, I must talk about the James Webb Space Telescope because it's freaking awesome! But by way of a longer and second introduction to this topic, I have a thing to say. I personally believe that there are two ways to make the world a better place. You can decrease the suck, and you can increase the awesome. Now, these are not mutually exclusive things. That's hard to say. Mutually exclusive. But they're also not the same thing. And it's clear that decreasing suck is extremely important, probably, in the end, more important than increasing awesome. And thus, when I talk about the space program, people are always like, NASA's money could be better spent on services for humanity. And to them I say, I do not want to live in a world where we only focus on suck and never think about awesome. If we lived in that world, then people would play soccer by having both teams stand and guard their own goal the whole game, with the ball sitting at midfield, and then at the end of the game we're supposed to all celebrate because no one scored any goals against our team. That's not gonna get you on SportsCenter. We have to guard the goal, and we have to try and prevent bad things from happening, but we also have to make good things happen. And that is why I love the James Webb Space Telescope. It's the space telescope version of a freaking awesome frick space telescope! This thing gives me serious nerdwood. So without further ado, my nerdy comrades, here are the top 5 reasons why the James Webb Space Telescope freaking kicks ass. It is huge! The total mirror size is 7.5 times larger than the Hubble Space Telescope's meter. The heat shield is the size of a tennis court. Number 4! It's a freaking transformer. Because it's so huge, it could never fit in its full form in the top of a rocket ship. And so in order to fit into the rocket, it's super duper folded up, and then when it arrives, it unfolds in like 12,000 different marvelous little ways that could go wrong at any moment, and it freaks me out because I worry about that. And oh, woe for humanity, no one is going to be there to see this thing open up. But luckily, the wonderful computer animators at NASA have given us the images that I have been showing you. Number 3, it will operate 1 million miles from Earth. That's about 4 times as far away from the Earth as the moon is. The Webb telescope actually orbits the sun. That's a simplification. It's actually in the relative stationary sun-Earth Lagrange point 2. Which I'm not going to try to explain to you right now. If it screws up, there's no way to fix it. You may have noticed that we went to fix the Hubble like 10,000 different times. Well, we're not gonna get that opportunity with the James Webb Space Telescope. One off, one chance to do it right, or it's a $6 billion piece of space junk. That is tense. Number 2, it will be able to see planets orbiting stars in our galaxy. Individual planets. If the James Webb Space Telescope was 25 light years away, it could see the Earth. It can also determine the chemical composition of planets, and it can peer into stellar nurseries to see planets as they form. Watch solar systems forming. And finally, the James Webb Space Telescope can see 13.4 billion years into the past. This is particularly impressive because the universe is 13.7 billion years old. We will be seeing the first galaxies as they form, the first stars as they form. And guess what? None of this is necessary to life on Earth. None of it's going to help us cure malaria or install a democracy in Egypt, but it is awesome in the truest sense of the word awesome. I'm sorry that there's so many hand gestures in this video. I am feeling very gestury. This is the dawn of everything that we know, and that is increasing awesome, and that is something that I can get behind. John, I'll see you on Friday.